Welcome to the NASA High Power Rocketry video series. High-powered rocketry is an exciting hobby that combines multiple disciplines within the fields of science, technology, engineering, and math. This series of videos provides an introduction to different aspects of high-powered rocketry and hopes that you will incorporate it into your classroom. We'll discuss several different topics, including rocket structure, electronics, avionics, rocket propulsion, payloads, recovery, and most importantly, safety. These videos are a supplement to a series of handbooks, which are available to download from the same webpage as these videos. The videos and handbooks are listed by topic, and we encourage you to download both for each topic. These videos are meant to be informational and educational, and are not intended to be instructional. You won't learn how to build a rocket from start to finish, but you will gain an overview so that with the help of an experienced and certified mentor, you will have an understanding of the basic principles involved. Please note that these videos are not intended to replace the guidance of an experienced high-power rocketeer. They are meant to supplement the guidance that your certified rocketeer will give you. Safety is of the utmost importance when building and flying high-power rockets, so it's absolutely vital to start the hobby under the watchful eye of a flyer with ample experience. We'll discuss some laws and regulations surrounding the hobby of high-power rocketry, but the information provided in these videos does not supersede any requirements or laws imposed by the authorities that have jurisdiction in the area where you'll fly your rocket. It's up to you to ensure that you meet all local, state, and federal regulations concerning high-power rocketry before you participate in any launch activities. High-power rocketry can be incorporated into the classroom in different ways. The handbooks available for download with these videos cover more in-depth theory of many of the concepts involved, and we'll go over some of those ideas as we move through the video series. At the hobby level, high-power rocketry is governed through either of two high-power rocketry organizations in the United States, the National Association of Rocketry, NAR, or the Tripoli Rocketry Association. Both organizations act as entities that regulate the activity of their members through a high-power rocketry safety code. It is vital to read, learn, and abide by these safety codes, as they ensure that your launches occur with the least amount of risk to you, others, and the launch property. These organizations also provide third-party liability insurance as long as it is a NAR or Tripoli sanctioned launch and all rules and regulations are followed. The organizations are divided into local prefects or clubs located across the country and that hold regularly scheduled meetings for its members. The meetings are informational, educational, instructional, and offer a time and place for members to gather, share projects, and enjoy time with fellow rocketeers. Local clubs are an ideal place to find a mentor.
It's advantageous for individuals and for teams to get networked with a local rocketry club. They've done the hard work of securing the FAA waiver and a place to host regularly scheduled high-powered rocketry launches. Additionally, many of the members in these clubs are work in the aerospace industry and can really help shorten the learning curve.
In order to fly high-power rockets at a sanctioned club launch, you must become a member of the organization through which the club is sanctioned. Some clubs are NAR, some are Tripoli, but most are both, and most high-power flyers are members of both. Now that you know about NAR and Tripoli, let's talk about becoming eligible to fly a high-power rocket. To become eligible, you must become high-power rocketry certified through either NAR or Tripoli. There are three levels of certification. Level 1, with the ability to fly rockets with an installed total impulse of up to 640 Newton seconds. Level 2, with the ability to fly rockets with an installed total impulse of up to 5,120 Newton seconds. And Level 3, with the ability to fly rockets with an installed total impulse of up to 40,960 Newton seconds. You must be certified at the level appropriate for your intended motor before you are allowed to purchase the motor. For example, if you want to fly a rocket that uses a motor with 5,000 Newton seconds total impulse, you must be level 2 certified to purchase that motor. You must successfully certify at one level before you can obtain the next level. The most important aspect of entering the hobby of high power rocketry is finding an experienced and dedicated mentor within a local club who's willing to show you how to safely build and fly your first high power rocket. High power rockets are fun and exciting, but they are much more hazardous than smaller model rockets. When building high-power rockets, you use power tools, handle potentially hazardous chemicals, measure and pour black powder ejection charges, use electric matches, solder and wire electronics, build rocket motors, and fly several pounds of hardware thousands of feet in the sky. Done properly, these operations are safe and enjoyable. Done incorrectly, they can result in severe injury and even death. Therefore, it's absolutely vital to find an experienced, certified mentor. We'll talk about safety throughout this video series, but remember, these videos are meant only to enhance your understanding of the process of rocketry. They are not meant to replace the role of a dedicated mentor. Videos, books, and articles are informative and helpful, but nothing is as valuable as the hands-on guidance from an experienced, knowledgeable mentor.
Well, I think it's very important to find a mentor because a mentor will be doing or will have done exactly what the teams are trying to do now. So this person will know the techniques to use, how to build a rocket, how to safely launch and fly the rocket.
Finding an experienced mentor when I was first starting out in high-powered rocketry, it was very important for me because they understood what works, what doesn't work in this hobby, where it cuts down my learning curve, and they can instill a sense of confidence in you that will ultimately end up in long-term success, especially when you're trying to figure out materials, working with energetics, which from a safety standpoint, it's very important to have that mentor to make sure that you're safe and you keep everyone around you safe.
At the end of many of the videos in this series, we will include examples of educational activities related to the topics in that video. These activities aim to help teachers utilize the rocket concepts discussed in the videos to engage students in lessons they may already be teaching in their classrooms and connect common classroom activities with real-world rocketry applications. For more information about NAR, Tripoli, or your local rocketry clubs and certifications, log on to either the NAR or Tripoli websites. Good luck in your high-power rocketry endeavors, and thank you for watching the NASA High Power Rocketry video series.